NASH is the most serious form of NAFLD. Histologically, it is characterized by the presence of steatosis, hepatocellular ballooning, and lobular inflammation with or without hepatic fibrosis. Of these features, ballooning and inflammation are considered to be the two key drivers of NASH activity and fibrosis. A significant proportion of patients with NASH will progress to cirrhosis, end-stage liver disease, and hepatocellular carcinoma. Those NASH patients with fibrosis are at increased risk of disease progression, and fibrosis portends a worse prognosis. Therefore, it is critical to resolve NASH before it has a chance to progress. Earlier this year, an article in Newsweek referred to NASH as the 21st century's looming public health threat. Over the past 25 years, obesity rates in the U.S. have more than doubled among adults and more than tripled among children. In fact, nearly 38% of American adults are now obese. Our children are following our lead. About 17% of children and teens from 2 to 19 years of age are obese. That's about 12.7 million children and adolescents. The global picture is not much better. Worldwide obesity has more than doubled since 1980, and much of the world's population today live in countries where overweight and obesity kills more people than underweight.
In addition to non-invasive testing on the horizon, it is critical that we increase awareness of fatty liver disease across other medical specialties, as hepatologists cannot find and treat all of the patients who have this condition. That means diabetologists, endocrinologists, cardiologists, and even general practitioners should all be aware of NASH and its untoward consequences if left untreated.
In fact, NASH is expected to surpass hepatitis C as the leading reason for liver transplantation in the near future. Furthermore, in addition to the hepatic burden of NAFLD, cardiometabolic risk seen in these patients needs to be addressed.
Because NASH is a chronic disease, it is essential that therapies are safe. As stated by the AASLD and the FDA, it is crucial, and for those already at high risk of cardiovascular disease, it is certainly mandatory to be able to control LDL, HDL, and triglyceride levels. The same is true for insulin resistance-related parameters, such as HOMA-IR or HbA1c. Last but not least, the silent nature of NASH means that drug therapy must be well tolerated by patients. Indeed, patients who may not feel sick may be tempted to stop therapy if treatment is not well tolerated. This may also be an issue for access, as payers may be less likely to reimburse drugs that patients are unlikely to tolerate.